So a very important 2 points up for grabs tonight, and a very important member of the Senators will be back in their lineup tonight as Martin Havlat completes his two-game suspension. And as we bring in Dean Brown and Greg Millen, guys, a lot of talk of revenge around these parts in Philadelphia. What do you think we'll see tonight?
Well, you know, Chris, I think both the coaches talked about this, and I think it's likely going to be the case. There's just too much at stake in the standings that you showed for anybody to go out and do something stupid. And now, if this game gets out of hand one way or the other, if Philadelphia or Ottawa gets a big lead, I don't think we can make the same guarantee, but I doubt we're going to see anything early.
No, I agree. This game is so important, that, and both teams are so excellent on the power play. Number one for the Flyers, number two in the National Hockey League on the power play. As we look at the incident one more time, Havlat, who cross-checked Recchi, no question he deserved the two-game suspension. I will tell you this, though. If the Flyers have a chance to line up Havlat, they will do it, because not only do they want revenge, but let's remember, he has 8 goals in his last 9 games before the suspension, so he's a marked man anyway.
The Flyers try to move it, except Bondra. Rather make that Brashear work it back to his own end. Puck goes up and out of play as Neal comes across to have a little meeting with Bondra. Rather make that Brashear after he gave Havlat a shove in the back in behind the play.
Well, you got to give Neal credit, don't you? He goes right after Brashear, who, by the way, is not very small. Well, here's the first taste of Martin Havlat getting a little whack here from the Philadelphia Flyers. Just a little shot from behind Brashear. An extra little shot here.
Along the boards. Here's Smolinski just trying to keep it in the zone. Does, and then he is decked by Amati. Along the boards, Schaefer taken down. We get a whistle. Smolinski is down, and Schaefer is slow in getting up.
We'll see. On the right of your screen, there's the first hit. A little late, blindsided. Smolinski goes down, and then, ooh, in the corner, Schaefer.
Point to the line. Wine fires, hits the lean, he holds on. And Brashear goes to the Ottawa blue paint and gets the elbow up in the face of Phillips.
Here is the play. And that's just careless use of the stick, and it's going to be a 2-minute penalty. Had Parthier here. He gives him a pretty good ride into the boards. Here comes Neal back in. And it didn't look like Brashear wanted any part of Neal on that particular sequence. Stay tuned, however.
Monty holds the puck in the zone, and lean forced to cover up and hold on, as again the Senators seem to be having a great deal of difficulty getting the puck out of their own zone. And now we get a little brouhaha.
Jason Spezza in the middle of it with Zamnoff, and I don't think that would be a very good idea, Mr. Zamnoff, because Spezza can throw them.
Back down ice. Solmik inside, flies it through. Loose puck save is made by Lalime on the redirect as it went off a skate to the Ottawa goal, and Lalime will cover up.
Sammy Kapanen back on the blue line again. An extra shot on Lalime that the Senators didn't like a whole lot.
Flyers with a comfortable 5-2 lead. Not going to take very many chances. Three of their four men back. Here's Fisher driving low. Puck in front of the net. As Fisher's driven into the net and then takes a slash from Esch.
They also had Claude Lapointe all tangled up with Daniel Alfredsson, and Phillips was in the area also. And here is the battle right in front of the Ottawa bench. And it was a wrestling match there. And then play continued in the other end. And after all that, I don't think there's going to be any penalties called. And here's the slash that you were talking about, Dean, as Fisher goes to the net with some authority. Oof.
Two line offside as Neal comes inside the zone, and he and Markov have a few words.
What's going to happen here, do you think? Now the ref's going to go talk to them.
Like a lot of good.
What's he going to do? Like, why is he doing? Is he begging them not to fight?
Off the draw. Here's Pothier with it now. Goes cross ice, and Simpson gets to center. Chips it in. Down low to the corner. Rob Ray goes in to get it. Grabs on to Kaplan. Back to the point. Popper's shot. Hits for Metz. Swings and spins it wide. Down in front of the net. Rob Ray and Brian Brashear. And finally they dropped him. The penalty call was on the way in the first place. As Ray comes in, lands a couple, took a couple in the first place. And now Brashear trying to yank his jersey off. Ray trying to get a hand free, falls, gets back up. And now Ray trying to come over the top of the right hand of his own. And I think Ray had been cut earlier in this fight as he took one really early. I think that was a helmet cut. If you look at where that cut is.
Look out here. And Simpson just went in after Brashear. Now he's pounding away. Anybody can get a hold of. Here goes Patty Lalime.
Esch comes in, so Lalime comes down ice.
They're going to go.
Oh, Esch won't take the mask off. Lalime does it for him. Lalime gets the sweater over top of the head of Esch, but he falls down. Now Esch tries to get another hand over the top.
This might be what the Senators needed. Now we got another one going in the corner. Looks like Sean Van Allen.
Radivojevic.
Yep. They're going. Are they ever going?
Well, Radivojevic is absorbing more than he's... I don't think he's thrown one yet. And I think Radivojevic has been cut.
The goalie's still at it.
Van Allen falls, and that gives Radivojevic a chance. And now gradually getting players off the ice.
And Simpson's still cruising around. Here, look out here. Old time hockey's back in Philadelphia. Started from the faceoff. Rob Ray out against Donald Brashear. You got the feeling something was going to happen. They follow each other all the way to the net. Ray's looking for anybody at this point. And he finds somebody. And away they go. And Brashear is one big man. And there go the goalies. They had some fun. And Patrick Alleen did a little better than his last fight. Who was that again, Dean?
Felix Potvin.
Felix Potvin, who's one of the tougher goalies in the league. Not much was thrown here.
And we'll see what, if anything, happens. And here's Neil right in front. And here we go again. And oh, Neil drops and then pounds Somek into the ice. Oh, that is nasty.
Now Chera's going. And he's just raining some. Oh, look out. Chera's got a hold of somebody. This isn't pretty either.
Oh, he's got Matty Tomander, and I don't like Tomander's chances here. He better just cover up here because he is going to get tagged bad. And Tomander is looking for help. He's wrestling Chera nicely to just keep himself out of the gunshot. And now the ref comes in.
And Hitchcock is hopping mad at Jacques Martin at the moment. He's chirping at him. And they're going to be partners soon, coaching Canada's team at the World Cup. Oh, are they hot down there?
So now a minute 42 to go in the third. This is how long it normally takes to finish the last minute and a half of a basketball game.
It's not over yet. Now, what's Hitchcock telling John LeClair? He's going over some things with him right now. LeClair, I don't think, bought it.
Let's go downstairs to Chris Simpson, see who she's fighting.
No one yet.
Well, if the Flyers were looking, well, I was going to say looking for their chance, Havlat's coming out, but he's been sent over to serve a penalty, so.
I don't think it'd be a good idea if he went on the ice at the moment.
Okay, now, I'm not sure exactly what's going on, but down on the Philadelphia bench, Donald Brashear is gearing back up. And now the referee goes over to tell him he's not even supposed to be in the runway. He's been ejected. But the guy was gearing back up.
Not anymore.
He had them bring his shoulder pads back because he'd taken them off. Well, after everything, it's 4-on-4. And right off the draw now, it's going to be Fisher and everybody in again. Fisher and Hanzus. Hanzus much larger, but I like Fisher's chances here. Oh, and he drops Hanzus with a hammer. Hanzus gets back up. Fisher throws him down again. Oh, Hanzus is not doing well here.
Hitchcock talked to Hanzus and John LeClair. LeClair shook his head going away from the bench. These two started it here when the puck dropped. Isn't that interesting?
Lots of room on both benches for the last 99 seconds, and now Dan Marinelli speaking with both head coaches. So we'll try and get this faceoff done again. This time it's Recchi and Smolinski. Off the draw, Recchi wins it. Puck floats back to the corner, and here's Kapanen back to get it. Recchi back up ice. Fires through the middle. Here's LeClair to the line. Sends it in. Redden goes to chase it. Here's Redden along the boards. Clears the puck ahead. Recchi comes across, and now we're going to get one going here. Redden and LeClair. And in front, Smolinski and Recchi. Smolinski comes back with a couple of rates over the top. Falls, gets back up. Recchi keeps going.
That's a pretty good one going at center ice.
Well, still a minute 15 to go in the third. The question will be, will either team have enough guys to finish the game?
And now Recchi points at the Ottawa Senator bench at Jacques Martin. So things continue to heat up. Now what? And these refs are going to go over another chat. Hey, boys, it didn't work last time, but you can try again.
I'm serious. There may not end up being enough guys left to finish the game. They still got a minute 15 to go.
The refs are begging right now. Please, guys.
I believe out of all this, Ottawa will get what amounts to an inconsequential power play, but what they do get is the odd man advantage in the event of another fight.
I don't think anything's going to happen this time with Sammy Kapanen on the ice. Oh, yes. Oh.
Spezza now going at his man. Oh, those two drop it as Spezza comes in, and he goes down as he got tangled up right after the faceoff with Patrick Sharp.
I told you, refs, it wouldn't work.
It's almost like now you don't want to be the guy who doesn't get kicked out of the game.
Well, now the Ottawa Senators are down to three on the bench, three on the ice. The Flyers down to four on the bench. I've been in this business a long time. I don't think I've ever seen this. Not like this.
Well, that whole thing took 2 seconds, so now we're down to a minute 13. Each team appears to have... Well, Ottawa's got six players left. Well, so do the Flyers. They have six each. So it's basically a three-on-three hockey tournament.
Yeah, no doubt about that.
Oh, and Spezza lands two good rights before he kind of gets twisted around and falls.
I've been around 25 years now in this game, and I don't think I've ever seen this. Ever. I've seen some pretty good goon shows. It used to happen on a regular basis, but not like this one, where they just keep going.
And that'll do it. Flyers win it 5-3 in what became a fight-filled closing minute and a half, or minute and 45 seconds to end this game. And the two teams head off. They will meet again April the 2nd, and you think there'll be any build-up for that? Stay with us. Post-game reaction on the way. 5-3, Flyers win it.